no, make it stop, 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 my ears.
Hey, Aokidz, it's Nazareth.
And Andres.
And welcome back to Aokidz Sunday School
Live.
We hope that your week has been absolutely spectacular. And today's lesson and today's episode is gonna be absolutely amazing. So, Andres, tell us more about it.
We have Bible stories, we have fist bumps, we have games, we have praise and worship, so many things to do this episode.
So get ready to stand up.
Get on our feet for praise and worship.
It was one of my favorite songs.
Me too.
I love to just dance and sing and jump.
But you know what else I love?
Is every single Aokidz episode.
That's right, because we always love to give you guys a great lesson straight from the Bible. And we always give you guys these three key points. I think we should go over last week's one more time.
Yeah, just in case you guys forgot what we talked about last week, we talked about a really important guy. What was his name again?
We started the story of Moses, a really important guy in the Bible.
That's right. So let's go over some key three points about the beginning of Moses' story.
Number one, God protected Moses because he was a special child.
That's right. Number two, Moses' mom trusted God with his life.
And number three, God had a purpose and a plan with Pharaoh's daughter.
That's right. You know, today we're having Moses part two.
Part two?
Yes, did you know that there was more to his story?
That's awesome. I kind of figured because where we left off, it was like the buildup, but we still learned so much. How much can we learn today?
I know, when we left off last week and he was still a baby.
But wait. Before we get into that, I think we have a friend that wants to share a special verse with us.
That's right, so take it away.
Hi, Aokidz, I'm Isa, and today I want to talk about Proverbs 3:5-6 that says, repeat it after me, trust in the Lord with all your heart and not lean on your own understandings. In all your ways, submit to him, and he will make your path straight. Good. So what this verse means is that Many times in life, and most of the time in life, we will be going through many obstacles and many bad things are going to be happening in our lives a lot of the time. So we need to make sure that we are putting all of our trust in God and that we have faith in God. Even if we do not understand why, even if we don't understand what's going on and why it is happening, because you will never understand it. God is the only one who understands. So we need to make sure that we put all of our faith in God, because God is the only one who can put you through, who can get you through all of the obstacles that you're going through, and who can take you out of everything that is going on. God is the only one who can do that. So we need to make sure that you are putting all of your faith, and you will see that you will get through all of your obstacles so much easier. Bye, Aokidz. Back to you, Nazrith and Andres.
Wow, thank you so much.
I love that verse. It's so powerful.
That's Proverbs 3, 5 through 6. I think we should go over it, and I think you should repeat after me one more time.
Yeah, let's repeat it all together.
So repeat after me.
Let's do it.
Trust in the Lord.
Trust in the Lord.
With all your heart.
With all your heart.
And lean not.
And lean not.
On your own understanding.
On your own understanding.
In all your ways.
In all your ways.
Submit to Him.
Submit to Him.
And He will make your paths straight.
Make your paths straight.
Amen.
Amen.
Proverbs 3:5-6.
That's right. It sounds like Moses probably trusted in God for something.
That's right, because the verse and the story usually go pretty hand in hand.
You know what?
Wait, you know what else goes hand in hand?
Fist bumps!
That was a good one. That was a good fist bump.
It was kind of clever.
Okay.
But you know what? I'm starting to get really anxious. I just really want to know what happens next.
Me too. So why don't we find out right here?
Let's do it.
This is Moses.
Hello.
Moses was an Israelite boy born in Egypt in a time when Israelite boys were not supposed to live.
Wait, huh?
The Israelites were slaves to the Egyptians. But God had a special plan for Moses.
Oh, eh?
And he spent his childhood in the palace of the Pharaoh. You see, when Moses grew up, he made a big mistake.
Uh-oh.
Pharaoh found out what Moses had done, and he tried to have Moses killed.
Ah!
So Moses ran away from Egypt. He stopped in the land of Midian. And seven sisters came to the well to give water to their father's flock. Some shepherds came to drive them away.
Hey, you.
But Moses stood up for the women.
Hey.
Now these sisters were the daughters of the Midianite priest named Jethro. When Jethro heard what Moses did for his daughters, he sent for Moses. So Moses came to live among the Midianites, and he married Zipporah, one of Jethro's daughters.
Huh?
Meanwhile, back in Egypt, the old Pharaoh died, but he was replaced by a new Pharaoh who continued to treat the Israelites poorly.
Aw, man.
The Israelites cried out to God because of the terrible things that the Pharaoh made them do. God heard these people and knew it was time to act. One day, Moses was tending Jethro's flock when an angel of the Lord appeared to Moses through a burning bush that would not burn up. Moses stopped to look at the bush, and he heard the voice of God say, "Moses, Moses."
Hello?
God then told Moses how sad he was because of the suffering of his people. He told Moses that he wanted to do something about it, and he wanted Moses to be the one to do it.
Oh, man.
But Moses did not think he was the right person to go. God said, "I will be with you."
All right.
But Moses said that he wouldn't know the right thing to say to the people. So God said to tell the people that God himself had sent him and promised Moses that his plan would be fulfilled through Moses. But Moses still said to God that he did not think the people would believe him. So God said, "What is that in your hand?" Moses said, "A staff." God told Moses to throw it on the ground. Then God told Moses to catch it. God showed Moses another sign. And told him to show these signs to the people if they did not believe what he said. Moses still didn't think he would have the right words to say. But God said that he himself was the one who made a man's mouth and gave him the ability to speak, so there was no need to worry. Yet even after all this, Moses said, "God, please send someone else." Then God got mad at Moses and said that he would send Moses' brother Aaron to speak for Moses. So Moses went back to his father-in-law and told him that he needed to go back to Egypt. Moses and his family started their journey back to Egypt, and Moses carried the staff of God in his hand, for this staff would be the tool God would use to demonstrate his awesome power to the Israelites and to the Egyptians.
Whoa!
That's a pretty juicy story.
Wow, so much time passed from where we left off to where we picked up today.
Yeah.
Because last time we saw Moses, he was just...
He was a little tiny, tiny, tiny baby.
That's right. And now we pick it up here and he's all an adult. But he grew up, even though he was an Israelite, he didn't grow up with the rest of the Israelites, right?
No, and the Israelites at this time were slaves. So it was probably a good thing that he didn't grow up with them because he didn't suffer the way they did.
Wow, that must have really sucked to see, like, your own people every day outside just slaving away, suffering for so many years.
Yeah, imagine it was, you know, your mom, your cousins, maybe your siblings, all his family.
You're my cousin.
Yes, we are cousins.
Fist bump! And I'm brown like Moses, right?
And I am the color of clouds.
Okay, close enough. So, Moses now, he's living in the Pharaoh's house because he grew up under the Pharaoh's daughter, right?
That's right. But eventually, when he grew up, he actually got kicked out.
Kicked out. You know, I have never gotten kicked out of a place ever. But I know people, for example, that like, for example, if you're stealing coins at Chuck E. Cheese, and then the people tell you you can never come back. That's kind of what they did to Moses, but with the whole Egypt.
And the whole kingdom.
Uh-huh.
And you know, the video didn't really say why he got kicked out, but I heard it was because he was defending a slave, an Israelite.
That's right, because you know what? He couldn't stand to see these people suffer anymore. And even though he stood up for one of them, he kind of hurt one of the Egyptian soldiers in the process.
And the Pharaoh got super, super, super duper mad and kicked him out.
That's right. Can you imagine living in one place your whole life? And then all of a sudden, you can never go back there again? What do you do? Where would you go?
It looks like Moses just went walking until he encountered these women that were at a well.
Wow, that's a good point. And you know what? Good thing that he was such a good guy and stood up for them and helped them out, right?
Yeah, he helped them out because then their dad, which ended up being his father-in-law, gave him a place to live.
A father-in-law? What does that even mean?
Father-in-law is like... like your dog?
No, father-in-law means that when you marry somebody, right? So when I marry my wife, her dad is gonna be my father-in-law because we're like connected through the wedding.
That's confusing.
Well, it's not your dog, so I think that he really, really, really must have liked this girl if he married her, right?
Yeah, they got married and then they were living in the same community with the father-in-law because they gave him a house and a place to live. And it just makes you think, right? Because, you know, Moses was chosen by God. And it just makes you show, it goes to show that maybe when Moses got, probably when Moses got kicked out of Egypt, he really didn't know what was coming next in his life. He didn't know where he was going to live. He didn't know what he was going to eat. Because imagine being, living in the kingdom, in the palace, you have all the food in the world. You have everything you could possibly want. And now he was probably worried that he wasn't going to have a place to go. But, you know, God always had his back.
You know, that's a good point. Because I was wondering, you know, God saved Moses from the soldiers for like 3 months, hidden away. Mm-hmm. Then he saved him in the river, in the basket. And he saved him by giving him, you know, letting him grow up with the Pharaoh's daughter. Mm-hmm. But all that saving, because he's so special and this purpose and plan that he has for him, just for him to get kicked out? Like, what is that? Like, did all of that saving, was it for nothing?
You know, that's a really good point, because sometimes in our own lives, we see, like, we know that God has a plan for us, and, you know, we're growing and growing and we're going up, but then we have these moments where we go down, and we have these bad moments in our lives, and we're like, wait, I thought I was special, I thought God had a plan for me. But, you know, some even though we go through bad seasons and bad chapters in our life, doesn't mean that God still has an amazing plan. It's all about trusting the process.
That's right. And you know what? The Bible says that God will make all things work for the good of those who love him.
Which is me.
And I love him.
And do you guys love Jesus?
I hope you do. But we know that Moses definitely did, because God still kept this plan going in his life. And God eventually showed himself to Moses in what I think is a pretty awesome way.
Yeah, and it goes back to that verse we were talking about, how trusting the Lord with all your understanding.
No. Do not lean on your own understanding, but trust the Lord with all your heart.
Do not lean on your own understanding, but trust the Lord with all your heart.
Uh-huh. That means that even when it doesn't make sense in your brain, we still trust God, because he is more stronger and powerful and smarter.
That's right. And it means that even if you can't see how the story is going to finish, mm-hmm. like us, because we don't know how Moses' story is going to finish, uh-huh. we still trust that God's plan went through.
That's right. And, you know, there's a couple more things. You know how when Moses goes and then he sees a bush and it's on fire, but it's not burning?
Have you ever seen a real fire?
Like a candle, yeah. But not like a, like, oh, I guess at the retreats, when we used to go to retreats, they would do the bonfire. That was one of my favorite parts. And we would sing, set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more. That was my favorite song to sing at the campfire, because it was like, oh, fire.
And then you're like eating s'mores?
Yes, and the s'mores too. That's a good one.
I love s'mores.
Well, anyways, you know how at the fires the wood is burning up into ashes and it's like, you know, the smoke and stuff? Well, this bush that Moses saw, it was like in the
kept
video.
Kept burning.
It kept burning, but it didn't burn up, meaning like the leaves weren't like crippling up and like when it is, they were just. Like, the fire
was on it, but it was not burning. But, like, the fire wasn't affecting the bush.
That's right. That's exactly right. But
wow, only God could do something as amazing as that.
And that's why God, you know, presented himself in that way. Because, you know, anybody could go up to, like, another person could be like, Nazareth, I am God. And you're like, what? No, you're just a regular person. But this talking bush that's on fire but not burning, this has to be God, right?
That's right. And so God sent a burning bush to grab Moses' attention. And then Moses saw the burning bush and God spoke to him.
Mm-hmm. And before Moses could even go close to the bush to hear what God had to say, he had to do one important thing.
Which was?
Taking off his sandals.
Ew!
Well, not really, because you guys see, God is so pure and so holy that where that bush was holy ground. And he couldn't step on it with the same dirty sandals that he was walking all over the desert with that had mud and sand and sheep poop on it. No way. That sandal was there to protect his feet from getting dirty, right? So his feet were the more clean ones, so that's why he had to take his sandals off.
So he took off his sandals, and it really showed that he was really in the presence of God.
That's right.
Can you imagine? Because, I mean, I know that God is always with us, but can you imagine, like, you know, like,
actually talking to God and
like
hearing his voice?
That's amazing.
That is amazing. And you know what?
What?
God said some pretty cool things in this very special conversation with Moses.
I know, I heard.
Mm-hmm. And when Moses asked the bush, like, God, like, who are you? Guess what he answered?
He said that I am the I am.
That's right.
The great I am.
He is the great I am. God says I am.
Wait, I'm kind of confused because, I mean, I thought God was Jesus, right?
Okay.
But I thought that God, that, what, isn't his name God and Jesus? Like, who is the I am?
Wow, there's a lot of names that we give to God because he's so awesome and because there's so many ways that we could describe him, right? So first of all, you know, we have the Trinity. We have God the Father, mm-hmm. God the Son, which is Jesus, mm-hmm. and God the Holy Spirit.
Yeah, I think I remember that we spoke about this a couple episodes ago.
Uh-huh. And well, also, there's lots of other names that people like to call him. For example, you know, like Jehovah Jireh means like the provider. Or like Abba, like Father.
Abba, Father, the Messiah.
The Messiah, our Savior.
The Savior of the world.
Uh-huh. The King of Kings, Lord of Lords, name above all names.
Wow, so God and Jesus have a lot of names.
That's right. There's so many more in the Bible. You want to go find them. Things like teacher, things like good shepherd, things like...
The I am.
The I am. So, but wait. Those are the ones that make a lot more sense.
Oh, wait. I kind of get it. Like, because my name is Nazareth, right?
Okay.
But some people call me Naz.
I call you Nazi.
Some people call me Nazi. Some people call me...
Nazara.
Nazarecita?
No, that's too long. Nazarecita.
So what are your nicknames?
People call me Andresito.
That's all you got?
No. One person called me Andy.
Oh.
And then one time in my school... People called me Dre for a little bit, but it didn't last very long. Like Andres without the an and the S, it was just Dre. I thought it was cool.
Anyways.
Okay. Anyways, I didn't understand when God said I am, that I am. Like, okay, like, so I am who I am too. Like, what's so special about that, right?
I am who I am too.
But God said, I am the I am, right? Meaning God is like the God.
Essence.
The essence of being, right?
Of existence.
He was
everything.
Exactly.
He
was there
it.
Before
he is
everything.
The I am the everything. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's right. You know, he was the first thing to exist. He's the Alpha and the Omega.
The beginning and the A-O-Kids.
So that's what that means. And those other things that he said in that fire.
That's right. He actually ended up telling Moses big, big news about his purpose because he chose Moses to free the Israelites.
That's such a big calling.
Okay, but you want to know a fun fact?
Sure.
About Moses?
What is it?
You know, Moses was really scared about his purpose and his calling when God told him.
I would be scared too.
Because Moses actually had a stuttering problem.
He had a problem?
Yeah, that's stuttering. So he had a stuttering problem where he stuttered, and that's why he was scared because in order to free the Israelites, he had to go speak to the Pharaoh.
Mm-hmm. And you know, even though... Now, some of us might giggle or laugh when other people stutter. You shouldn't make fun of somebody for stuttering because, you know, it's not really their fault. It's out of their control. One time, this girl had a lisp, you know, when people can't pronounce, like, their S's correctly. They say, for example, like, ethereal, like that. You know what I mean? And then people in my class started making fun of her.
My mom doesn't know how to say yellow. She says jello.
Like that. And then when the teacher made those kids apologize, you know what they said?
What?
Sorry.
Oh, that's mean. You know what that's called? A bully. And God doesn't like bullies.
Exactly. But, you know,
God wants us to be nice to everyone.
Moses had this stuttering problem, right? Mm-hmm. And, you know, he was like, how am I going to go talk to the Pharaoh if I can't even speak correctly?
I know. So he was really scared because he had this stuttering problem. So he was like, God, like, out of everybody in the whole universe, why would you choose me that I can't even speak? speak well, that I'm a little shy, because sometimes some people are shy, so that I'm a little shy, why would you pick me and not pick someone who is able and capable of doing this? But God knew that he was the perfect person to do it.
And let's not forget, Moses had already made a mistake and been kicked out of Egypt. Now he had to go back there with his stuttering problem with this big news that, guess what? Hey, Pharaoh, you know, all these people that are working for you for free and building all your beautiful buildings, towns, and pyramids, you know, that's it. That's gone. We're taking them back. We're leaving. We're out of here. You know, Moses, Pharaoh isn't going to like that.
And Pharaoh, you know, he was always a guy who kind of had like a temper, and he would get really mad when people didn't listen to what they did. And the punishments for that were really severe. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, Moses was literally putting his own life at risk. And he wasn't even like, he wasn't like that guy that was brave and could speak strong and was an extrovert and
like
was
outgoing.
No, not like you.
Like me, I'm strong. Anyways, you know what I think?
What?
That if I just went up to somebody and I said, like, imagine Moses going back to his wife and being like, mi amor, babe, guess what? And then she's like, what? And then he's like, I just spoke to God in a burning bush. Would you believe that guy? I don't think I would. He must be seeing things, going crazy, maybe too hot in the sun. So Moses asked God, you know, how am I going to tell these people that it's actually you still talking to me, talking to these people? You know what I mean?
Yeah. And then he turned his staff into a snake.
Why did you just spoil it all? I wanted to develop it some more.
Because God is so amazing that he can prove to others that he really is the Son of God. Kind of like he shows miracles. But since he wasn't there, he turned a staff into a snake.
That's right. And that's such a crazy thing. Can you imagine dropping a stick? Do we have a... Where's the pencil that we use? Here it is.
I don't know. Go fetch it. But, you know, God always comes through, because, you see, that was one of Moses' other worries. He was worried about, wait, how are people going to believe me? I'm going to go, and I'm going to sound like a crazy man, like crazy pants. But he had to trust God that God had a plan, and God did.
All right, guys, watch this. Are we ready? Here's my staff. Watch this. I'm going to drop it. Oh my goodness. Look what it turned into.
That was the worst trick I've ever seen in my life.
Well, for Moses, it really happened. He was able to just pick up the snake and turn it back into a stick. That's a pretty cool trick, huh? Not even a trick, a miracle. But that's a pretty cool thing to just whip out to people, like, oh, you're bothering me? Boom, snake stick.
That's right. So, you know, Moses had all these problems, and he was like, no, I can't speak correctly. I'm not brave enough. I got in trouble. I can't even, how am I going to even prove to these people that you're actually, like, how are they going to even believe me? But you know what? God knew that despite all of those problems that Moses could still do it. And, you know, it kind of relates to us, because sometimes we have all these problems and we have all these insecurities, and we always think, you know, I'm not good enough. You know, I'm too skinny. I'm too big. I'm not smart enough. I'm too shy. And we always say that I can't, but God always tells you that you can. And God actually puts us in these uncomfortable situations so that we can challenge ourselves and so that we can grow.
Oh my goodness, you're so right. I totally forgot to do that, to connect the story to our own personal lives and put ourselves in Moses' position.
That's right. And because Moses was an actual human being like we are, and he actually felt emotions, and it's displayed through his story, all those worries that he had that some of you and some of us may have nowadays. Mm-hmm.
And remember, the Bible isn't just a nice storybook or a nice book for cool verses and one-liners like, Jesus loves you forever. You know, the Bible is also like a history book. It's like the coolest history book ever, but it's still a history book. You know, all these things happened, and we can like have to imagine what would it like to actually be there.
You know, that's right. You know what? I kind of look up to Moses.
You know what? Me too. But we have to see if he actually goes through with it. You know, he has to go tell his wife, hey, babe, I'm leaving to Egypt, back over there, and freeing all the slaves.
I know, but we don't get to find that out till
next week.
That's right. But before anything else, we have key 3 points that we want you guys to jot down. So we're gonna give you this opportunity to go get a paper, a pencil, so you guys can jot down these 3 key points about today's lesson. Because you know, Moses is just so interesting.
Here, I'll get my pencil.
bunny.
Got it.
Whoa!
All right, point number one. Moses was banished from Egypt for defending God's people.
That's right. Number two, God spoke to Moses through a burning bush.
And number three, God used Moses despite his weaknesses.
That's right.
And if you guys want to have this type of, you know, connection and communication with God, right? Because even though God doesn't, you know, just show up in burning bushes or like a burning palm tree, because we live in Miami, fist bump, or like something else that's crazy, you know, we can have this personal conversation and relationship with God.
We can, but how do we do that?
Well, it's really simple. All you have to do is accept Jesus into your heart and give your life to God.
How do I accept Jesus into my heart, though?
It's a really quick, simple, easy prayer. You can do it right now, wherever you're at. All you have to do is repeat after me.
I want to do this prayer. Do any of you guys want to do this prayer?
Well, if you do, I encourage you to bow your head, close your eyes, and just repeat after me, because the Bible says, as long as you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that Jesus is Lord, you will be saved.
That's right. Let's do it.
So repeat after me. Say, Dear God,
forgive me of my sins.
Jesus, come into my heart. To be my Lord. And my Savior. I believe.
That you died for my sins.
And resurrected. I give my life to you. I love you. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Fist bump.
So, now, based on the lesson, we're gonna do Aokidz.
That's
right.
I don't like quizzes, but I like Aokidz.
Aokidz are the best. So
that's right.
Let's test ourselves to see if we really learn about today's lesson.
All right, here it is. Question number one. Why did Pharaoh kick Moses out? Which one could it be?
Look at all your choices. Make sure that you read them very carefully.
I don't want to give it away, but which one could it be?
And the correct answer is B.
That's right. No, I kind of said it. I'm sorry, guys. I was just trying to help out the Aokidz.
Whatever.
Wow, he was defending a slave, and that's why he got kicked out. Not fair, huh?
That's right. Number two is a true or false. So, you have a 50-50 chance of getting this right.
Well, you shouldn't be guessing, though. You should know the answer 100%.
But, don't fail me, Aokidz.
Number two. You can read it.
True or false? The new Pharaoh was nice to the Israelites. False! That is false. When the old Pharaoh died and there was a new Pharaoh, he was very mean to the Israelites, the same way the old Pharaoh was.
That's right. Number three, how did God speak to Moses?
Make sure you look at all your choices carefully.
I know it. We talked about it. You guys better know it.
We talked about it for a good 5 minutes.
All right, so here it is. The answer is C.
C as in cat,
even though it was a B, burning bush.
C as in chicharrón.
C as in cookie.
Okay, chocolate chip cookie has three C's.
C as in cucaracha.
Ew. Okay, last question. True or false? You want to read it?
I'll read it. Moses took off his sandals when talking to God.
That's a tricky question.
True or false? Sandals on, sandals off.
Sandals up or down? And the answer is
true. That's right. Moses took off his sandals because...
Did you hear that?
You know what that means. Game time! I'm so excited.
So what are we playing today?
Today we are playing a game called the Whisper Challenge.
Wait, I think I've seen this on TikTok.
Whatever. We wanted to bring it to Aokidz. So what we're going to be doing is setting up really quick. We're going to get some really loud...
So pause momentarily.
All right, this is the Whisper Challenge. Naz is going
to... What? What'd you say?
Nazareth is gonna have loud headphones on so she can't hear anything. Wait, what? We're not starting yet. Take it off.
You want me to take it off?
Yes. There you go. So it's really loud and we're gonna have a phrase and that phrase is gonna be, put them on.
Okay. I'm putting them on now.
Okay.
All right.
That phrase is gonna be right here. All right, that's the phrase. And then we're gonna look at each other and I'm gonna mouth it out. And then she's gonna try and guess what I'm trying to say. When she gets it, she wins.
Are you done explaining?
Yes. All right, let's look at each other.
Do I face you?
A little bit, yeah.
Okay.
All right. Are you ready? Remember, guys.
I'm ready.
Remember, guys, the phrase is, I love cheeseburgers. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, let's do this. You ready? I love cheeseburgers. Bruh, it's too easy. I got it.
It was easy. Did I take it off?
Remember, the phrase is, I want to build a snowman. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right. I want to build a snowman.
I watched The Greatest Showman.
No.
No?
I want to build a snowman.
Again.
I want to build a snowman.
You're going too fast.
I want to build a snowman.
You want to build a snowman.
Yes! Wait. Fist bump. All right, it's my turn. Maybe that was a little bit too easy. Maybe she should take it up a notch. Are you guys ready?
I'm just good at reading lips.
Oh, really? Okay.
I have a talent.
All right, here it is. I'm going to start the song over. You guys can go ahead, find out what your next word is going to be, or next phrase.
Okay, guys. So the next phrase is, can you hear me?
A little bit.
Well, then put it louder.
Okay.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay,
I'm ready.
Guys, remember, the phrase is...
What are you saying?
I haven't started yet. Okay, ready?
Okay.
You're ready?
I'm ready.
All right, let's do it. The rooftop is caving.
The move was heavy.
No. The rooftop is caving.
The rooftop left. The rooftop is heavy.
No. The rooftop is caving.
The rooftop is...
Caving.
Left.
Caving.
Levy.
Caving. Caving.
Taffy.
Caving.
Gappy.
Caving. The rooftop.
The rooftop is.
Caving.
Heavy.
Caving.
You're saying heavy.
Caving. Caving.
Again.
Caving.
La.
K. K.
G.
K.
K.
Uh-huh. Bing.
The rooftop is.
Caving.
Kevy.
Caving. Caving. It's caving.
It's caved. The rooftop is caved in.
Caving.
The rooftop is cavy.
Yes.
That doesn't make any sense.
It's caving.
It's caving. Caving. I guess. Oh, my ears. Wow, it's really loud.
All right, my turn.
Your
One
turn.
More time?
One more, maybe two. I don't know. It's pretty
okay.
fun.
Let's do it.
All right, here we go. Are you guys ready? The phrase is, I saw your mom at Walmart. Here we go. I saw your mom at Walmart.
Again?
I saw your mom at Walmart.
Something about your mom in Walmart. You lost your mom in Walmart?
I saw your mom at Walmart.
You saw my mom at Walmart.
What the heck? I thought it'd be hard.
I have a gift.
Yeah, with lips.
Okay, Aokidz, it's my turn. Okay, my phrase is, the cheating cheetah choked on cheddar cheese. He's never gonna get this one.
What'd you say?
We're starting.
We're starting.
Are you?
I won.
No. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right. We're starting. Ready? Okay. The cheating cheetah choked on cheddar cheese.
The CC.
Okay.
CC's pizza.
Okay. The cheating cheddar. I mean, I'm sorry. The cheating cheetah choked on cheddar cheese.
The seashell. Bro, the sea shark.
No. The cheating cheetah.
The chi-chi.
The cheating cheetah. The cheating cheetah.
The shishi shasha.
The cheating cheetah.
The chi-chi.
The cheating cheetah.
The cheetah.
The cheating cheetah.
The she cheetah.
The cheating cheetah.
The
cheating.
Cheating. Little Caesars.
Cheating.
Fast.
The cheating.
The cheetah.
Cheating cheetah.
Cheating cheetah.
Uh-huh. The cheating cheetah choked on cheddar cheese.
The cheating cheetah chose chess.
The cheating cheetah choked on cheddar cheese.
The cheating cheetah chose liars.
Choked.
Close.
Choked.
Notes.
Choked.
Toes.
Choked.
Glowing.
Choked.
Toast.
Choked.
That's toast. You're saying toast.
The cheating cheetah.
The cheating cheetah.
Choked.
Toast.
Choked. Choked.
Toast.
Choked.
Choked. Thank you.
Okay, the cheating cheetah.
The cheating cheetah choked.
On cheddar cheese.
On Cheez-Its.
Cheddar.
On cheddar cheese.
Yes!
The cheating cheetah choked on cheddar cheese.
Yeah, he got it.
I got it.
After
wow.
like 100 tries.
I tried my best, at least.
So I think it's very clear who the winner is.
I think
this girl, this girl, this girl.
I guess we get to still
this month. But you know what's even more fun than this game?
And listening to loud music.
It's when we get on our feet.
Stand up for praise and worship.
Glory's break.
Love Me Some Praise and Worship.
I love that song.
Well, before we go, we have a couple of announcements for you guys.
That's right. Our first announcement is that every Tuesday,
which is in two days,
we have our very own Connect Group.
That's right. There's room in a Zoom for you.
That's right. Our very own assistant leaders are the ones that run these Connect Groups, and they're super amazing. It's super fun to get to know more about Jesus and to make new friends.
That's right. It's the best way to stay connected.
That's right. So we encourage you guys to get connected through our Connect Groups.
Additionally, every single Friday, Aunt Cindy, we're having our services in person, physically.
That's right. You heard us here live in person in Alpha and Omega Church. So we want to invite you guys, if you guys want to come to our services, they're on Fridays at 8 o'clock and on Sundays in 3 different services.
That's right. So make sure you guys show up, bring a mask. We're going to stay social distance, but it's going to be a great time to see all of you guys right here in person.
And our last announcement, which is probably the most interesting announcement.
So, we're happy to announce Bible Fundamentals coming to you February 5th is the day we are starting, but you can register right now.
That's right. And all of this information that we've given to you, you can find it on our Instagram, AO_kids
with a Z,
or aomiami.org under the kids section.
That's right.
So before we go, should we do one last fist pump?
Fist pump!
And one for you guys.
Fist pump.
Okay, all right, go.
I lick the back of my knee.
What?
I lick. The back.
My thumb back.
The back.
My thumbnail.
The back.
What? I can't hear you.
The back.
Thumbnail.
I lick.
What? What? What was it?
I haven't finished. Go. You gotta get at least close.
I like.
I lick.
You did good at first.